coronaviruses are so named because they look like they have a crown around them on electron microscopy. And coronaviruses have been around for a long time. Some of them cause common colds. You may be familiar with SARS and MERS, but this one, COVID-19, is brand new. Well, it's really important for you to take care of yourself with this easily transmissible COVID-19 virus. The first thing you can do is simply wash your hands. You have to use warm water, make it soapy, and do it for at least 20 seconds. If you don't have soap and water available, then use a hand sanitizer, but make sure it has at least 60% alcohol. A third thing you can do is to avoid handshakes. And then finally, make sure you don't touch your face. But most importantly, if you're feeling ill, you want to stay home. You also want to avoid people who are ill, because frankly, taking care of yourself is also taking care of our community. We're all in this together. If you suspect that you've been exposed to someone with no coronavirus, or you come from an area that has an intense outbreak, then the current recommendations from the Centers for Disease Control are that you quarantine yourself for 14 days. That's thought to be the time period for incubation. In other words, the time which the virus would grow and also be contagious. So that time frame is to avoid you infecting others, at the same time making sure that you're tracking your own symptoms. Now, if your symptoms get worse, then it may be time to notify a health professional. And these symptoms can be very similar to the common cold or from the flu, including muscle aches, coughs, fevers. But the one that will require immediate attention is if you develop shortness of breath or difficulty breathing. That's a time when you not only need to contact a provider, but you should consider going to emergency department or even contacting 911 if someone's severely ill. Once someone's evaluated for potential coronavirus, the first test you might get will be for the flu, because the flu is more common than the coronavirus, and we want to make sure that you don't have the flu. If you do have the flu, there are medications that we can give it right away if your symptom duration has been short enough. But if the flu test is negative and you have persistent symptoms, or if you're severely ill, then you're going to get a COVID-19 test. That should be performed either in an emergency department, a hospital laboratory, or your doctor's office might be able to arrange that. Once the decision to take a coronavirus test is made, then you're presumed to be positive because you've tested negative for other things and you're in a high-risk category given your travel or exposure or symptoms. During that time, you'll probably be observed either at home with close follow-up by a healthcare provider or in a care setting, including a hospital. It's only when that test comes back negative that you'd then be released from that status. If the test comes back positive, then you still might not need to be admitted, but you're going to be very closely monitored. One, to make sure your condition is treated appropriately, and number two, to make sure you don't infect others, because you're now proven to have the disease. There are many treatments available for a flu, but not for coronavirus. We're doing experimental therapies for antiviral drugs that have been shown to work against MERS and SARS, which remember are also coronaviruses, but have not yet been proven to work against COVID-19. The other things we can do are to develop vaccines, but it's gonna take time to make sure they're effective, make sure they're safe, make sure they're appropriate for use in people. So don't expect one anytime soon. The final opportunity is to take advantage of those people who survived the COVID infection. This has been shown to be an effective strategy in flu, and it might be possible to take the antibodies from those people who've been exposed to COVID-19, survive, and then identify antibodies to give that same immune protection to ill people. The challenge with that one in the short term is just takes a lot of people to be infected. It takes time to get the treatment right, and you've got to make sure the resulting treatment's effective. So the best strategy in this is avoidance. Protect yourself, protect your community, and work on this together to make everyone as healthy as we can be. Drexel has been very proactive in terms of addressing the needs of our students, our faculty, and staff in preparation for the coronavirus outbreak. Under Drexel leadership, we have put together our experts in medicine, nursing, health professions, public health, administration, HR, research, facilities, IT, and all those components necessary to be sure we're well prepared on behalf of our students, faculty, and staff. We have a special hotline set up for faculty and staff who have questions or feel like they need further treatment or care for coronavirus. We have a dedicated email so employees can notify the university and subsequently their supervisors about any absences, self-quarantine, or care they need to pursue. And our Student Health Center has beefed up its personnel and practices to take on the needs of our students in this ever-changing dynamic of coronavirus outbreak. This university is well prepared. This university's dedicated. This university's committed to the health and well-being of our students, faculty, and staff. And we will, together, take on the challenges of this COVID-19 virus. I'm asked a lot about the need for a flu shot during this coronavirus outbreak. So no, the flu shot will not protect you against coronavirus, but the flu shot will help protect you against flu. And it's all part of the necessary preventive measures to keep yourself healthy during this season, but also during this outbreak. Follow those personal protection guides. Wash your hands. Don't touch your face. Clean surfaces. Avoid people who are sick. And if you become sick yourself, be sure that you isolate yourself from the rest of the community. We're all in this together to be healthy and as successful as we can.